What's up, you guys? I'm just checking in for a real small project. I again wasn't even gonna film this, and I said, what the hell? It may turn out decent, so I decided I'd go ahead and document it. What I'm doing here is nice new little chip. Awesome. Good thing I got Dr. Color chip. That one's my fault. What I'm doing is blacking out the red stripe that I just saw someone on Facebook or whatever, one of my groups, do it, and I like it, but I don't think I can get a clean enough job to keep it, so I wanted to just try it. So all I got here is some 3M vinyl. I haven't cut it yet, of course. I'm just decided to start filming right in the middle here in the job, and to just take razor cuts, super soft, and you can see maybe that you can kind of see the lines, top and bottom, like that's the chrome line. So that's one cut, and then there was another nice indent here, so it kind of gives you an idea where to cut it, although it will be very hard to get it exactly right, you know. And to tuck in this back edge, it's possible, might work, it's possible, but just like this, if you look close, I kind of like that look, and leaving the red for the lights, it's too much red for me in the front. I mean, it's always been that way. I just, you know, that's how they come. Not much you can do. And it is matching the headlight. But I just want to try it with the black grille. Although I'd like to get rid of the chrome, I'm going to keep that. And so here you can see I'm going to cut it on this crease at the top and a crease between the chrome and the red. That's what you saw over there. And I'm just going to leave the chrome for now because the whole thing is chrome. It'll match something. And don't forget, I do have the sweet black emblem right now. This is not the PP front emblem, even though this is a PP car. I bought a non-PP front emblem for this, which means it does not have raised borders and it's not sunken in where the sticker goes. So what this does is, for me, it makes it a lot cleaner. It's a lot easier to get the sticker on a flat, totally flat letter and match up all your borders. Look how killer they are. And with the PP, you have to sink it into the hole, and it's such a tight fit. So a lot of times you won't get it exactly perfect. So the non-PP emblem is a lot easier to work with than the PP emblem with the raised edges, with the raised outlines. So anyway, that's what I'm doing. I'm going to do a few more cuts on this side, see if I can get it right. Luckily, I had a nice pile of old vinyls left, and I just happened to have the right amounts. I said, hey, it's free. I'll play with it, see what it does, and we'll go from there. All right, I'll be right back. Just showing you a little bit of the first cut. I'm not gonna try and film and cut at the same time because it takes a very steady hand going along this line right here. Luckily, the line guides you a bit, but that does look pretty dang clean right there so far. So I'm gonna just put the camera down and keep working on it very carefully, see what I got. All right, so the bottom cut goes real nice. The top cut is a bit harder. You can see little bumps, and then you see red on this side. That bottom, the top one has a lot less play, you know. There's a deeper groove in the bottom, so you can get away with a little more. But see this right here, I'm trying to think, how could I do that? There is like no gap between here. And it would just be super hard to tuck it in that way and cut it properly. Of course, I do have more vinyl, you know, to play with it and try it again. But that's pretty tricky to get that top piece in right. And before you even say it, of course, I had the whole grill off today and looking at the red stripe, is there a way to get it off and do it super clean? And there, without breaking anything, there isn't. There's like 20 clips on the back of that thing. Most of them are so stiff, they're just going to snap when you start prying on all of them. It would be bad to just try do it. It would end up bad. So you really have to try do something on the car. Something that may work better than vinyl is some of that striping tape that I've used before. I think I got reds. I don't think I got blacks, but that's not a bad idea. I'm going to check all my storage boxes up here, see if I do got any black in there. That's an idea, but I don't think I do, but I may have some left. And some black tape, I'm just saying, if it's a nice width, would be a lot easier. That looks like a half inch red right there, half inch width. It'd be a lot easier to do that and not have to razor it and get it covered really nice. So let me look around some more. Obviously, I'm not going to leave this with a big red piece showing through. That's why I'm testing it. That's why I'm playing with it. So here's another way to think about doing this. When I lay the vinyl, I could lay the top perfectly so it does not need a cut. And then it'd be perfect. The bottom is easy to cut. So I would not put extra above the top. I would very carefully place it right on the line with a perfect cover, then do the two sides and the bottom trim later. That's what I'll try next. Worth a shot. So that one worked pretty well, guys. Now that you can see, there is no red anywhere. And I just laid the vinyl edge at the top, and now it did take a curve too. And of course, I'm using special Vivid vinyl gloves. Try to keep the fingerprints off it. A couple little dots and stuff, but not too bad overall. Take a felt squeegee a little bit. And I have a smaller one too, but this one might be all right. Try to get those edges tight. This edge is almost impossible because there isn't a hole there. It like butts into the grill, so it's really hard. And then maybe a little bit on the top lip there without messing it up. That's a pretty freaking sweet job right there, tell you the truth. That's pretty freaking nice. I'm surprised. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do the other side and just, see how I like it for a couple days. If I don't like it, it's easy to peel it off in 5 seconds. So I'm gonna see if I like the red-only lights or if I like the, right now, that's why I'm doing it. I like the blacked out grill. It looks really good to me. Car is pretty dirty. There's spots, you can't really see them, but I can see them. It's been raining and stuff, so it's not like it's a clean car. But yeah, that's not bad. That's not bad at all. Super easy. All right, let me do the other one. I'll show you the final result in a little bit. Damn, guys, that worked pretty well. Check out the other side. Also pretty freaking flawless. Although I would rather have a professional black plastic, it won't show as many little weird things as some vinyl would. So if anybody, I mean, not aftermarket though. I know how those aftermarket grills fit, that they never snap in quite the same as OEM. I've had some aftermarket grills on my Mark 7, but not a bad freaking result. And now I'll have to see if I like it. I don't know. I might just get tired of it and say I like it sleeper. But this just looks kind of interesting, on a white. Not too bad. So I'll have to watch the video because I can't really get a good view because it's right in my face right now, I hope this is straight. My front LCD is sideways right now. I hope it's not messing up the video. But I'll have to look at my own video here. So I'm gonna get a few shots and I can just look at it and see if I like it, which is all that matters as far as whether I'm gonna keep it or not. So we'll go there. Man, I hope this video isn't freaking 90 degrees off. I'm starting to get a bad feeling. All right, guys, we'll see it later. We'll see what happens. I may have to rotate this video or something. All right, talk to you later.